Well, good morning. Hey, wherever you're watching from, we hope that you're encouraged here with us in this time. I'm just going to read a scripture really, really quick, and it applies to the praise that we're about to give to our King and our God. And I love this verse because it goes against everything that we feel that this world would have us to know. You know, and it reminds me that it's even in this moment, no matter what we're going through, God's word is still applicable. It is still true. It is still reigning over everything, regardless of what's going on around us. In 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9, but he says to me and he says to you, right where you are, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in your weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest in and on me. And man, that's just not an easy thing, right? To boast about our weaknesses so that his power and his grace and his mercy and his favor rests within us and on us. But we come together in this time and we do just that. And we say, we trust you, Jesus, regardless of what's going on around us. We're showing up, we're here in this moment together, and we're gonna trust you that your promises are good, and we're gonna sing to you because you're a faithful God. We're gonna give you our praise. And so we just wanna encourage you that with this morning, right now as we worship together.
The power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of glory, the King above all kings, who shakes the whole earth with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder. The King of glory, the King above all kings.
If you know it where you are, sing it.
This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You'd lay down your life. Me.
Yeah. Come on, sing it. Who brings our chaos?
Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory, who rules the nations with truth and justice. Shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Yeah. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me.
So we thank you, Jesus, for that sacrifice.
You're worthy, is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who slain. Worthy is this King who conquered the grave. Worthy is the Lamb who slain. Worthy is the King who conquered the grave.
Our prayer this morning, God, awaken us in your spirit.
Now there were walls between us. By the cross you came and broke them down. You broke them down. And there were chains around us. By your grace we are no longer bound. No longer bound. You called me out of the grave. You called me into the light. You call my name and in my heart came alive. We say, your love is greater, your love is stronger, your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. Your love is greater, your love is stronger, your love awakens, awakens, awakens me.
Here's the truth.
Oh, now I feel the darkness shaking. All the dead are coming back to life. Oh, back to life. Hear the song awaken. All creation singing, we're alive. 'Cause you're alive. You call me out of the grave. You call me into the light. You call my name and in my heart came alive. Your love is greater. Your love is stronger. Your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. Your love is greater. Your love is stronger. Your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. Yeah. What a love we found. Death can't hold us down. We shout it out, we're alive, 'cause you're alive. What a love we found. Death can't hold us down. We shout it out, we're alive, 'cause you're alive. And what a love we found. Death can't hold us down. We shout it out, we're alive, 'cause you're alive. Stronger, your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. Your love is greater, your love is stronger. Your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. Your love is greater, your love is stronger. Your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. Your love is greater. Your love is stronger. Your love awakens, awakens, awakens me. It's your love awakens me. Oh yeah. This is amazing grace. This is a feeling love that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that we would be set free. Oh, as we sing for all that you've done for us.
Dear Jesus, we come in your name and we sing those words, but we believe them in our hearts as well. And so I pray that today, in a brand new way, your grace and your mercy and your power would rest in and on our lives as we look to you, as we trust you, as we open your word together. Lord, we love you. All these things we ask in your name, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Hey, good morning. I have been thinking about you. I pray that you are doing well. Man, we as your church family, we love you. We are cheering for you and all of the guests tuning in. Thank you for being with us this morning. I hope you are well. Well, I was talking to my mom. They live back in the Midwest, and she had my niece and nephew over for the day, and they decided that they were going to paint rocks. Yes, because that's where we are in life right now, is we're painting rocks, but they decided to paint rocks, and they painted one with this really cool penguin that was actually quite intricate. I was very impressed. And then they were painting others, just bold colors and glitter, things that little kids do. And then they took all these rocks after they dried a little bit, and they went out into the front yard. They hid them all over the lawn, and then my niece and nephew, who are 4 and 6, they went on a rock hunt. And let me tell you, it was like the hit of the day. After weeks of doing the same things, these kids were so excited and full of joy. My mom was awesome. This was the best thing they could have done all day. They went on a rock hunt. And that got me thinking about a verse I've been reading through and just thinking about lately, and I'd like to read it for you if we can jump right in together. So in the book of Lamentations, back in the Old Testament, starting in chapter 3, there's a verse that may be familiar to some, and here's what it says. Lamentations 3, starting in verse 22, it says, "Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed. For his compassion never fails. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness." Oh man, what an encouraging verse to like read over and really ponder and say, is this actually true that the Lord has great love? And because of that great love, we are not consumed. We're not consumed by a to-do list. We're not consumed by decisions. We're not consumed by depression. We're not consumed by despair. We're not consumed by loneliness. We're not even consumed by our drive and our desire. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed. I thought the part of the verse was so incredible that God's love is faithful. We can count on it. It says the Lord's, we are not consumed. His compassions, what do? They never fail. We can count on it. It is a sure thing. It is the best thing that you and I can choose today to lean on, to put our trust in, to have confidence that it will not change. The love of the Lord is steady and constant. We can trust it. It will come through. And I love this part of the verse. Maybe you didn't catch it the first time. Here's what it says. It says every morning that the love of God, the mercy of God, it is new every morning. What does that mean? It means every morning. It means today when you opened up your eyes, there is a new wave of God's love and God's mercy that is available to you. And I started thinking about this. Of sometimes, I don't know about you, but my heart can get numb. My mind can get numb to some of these great truths in the Bible. And I felt like God said, Diana, I promise that my love never fails, and my love and my mercy, it is brand new. There's a new experience of it every single morning. And I feel like the Lord asked me this question. He said, do you notice it? Do you notice it? Do you see the love and the mercy of God in and amidst your day? Do you catch it? Or have you actually gone through the last couple of days and you haven't even noticed the presence of God, the love of God, the goodness of God, the character of God in and amidst your day? I've been there. If it's new every morning, have we noticed it? And so I wanna ask a very concrete question of what would it look like if you and I, like my niece and nephew who went on a rock hunt with their mom, with their grandma, my mom, what if you and I went on a mercy hunt this weekend? I know it's a little cheesy, but hang with me. It might be as compelling and invigorating as my niece and nephew hunting for rocks in their yard. Maybe hunting for mercy will bring back the joy and the life and the connection and the wonder that maybe has dwindled a little bit. What if you and I are mercy hunters? Now, a fair question you might be asking is, yes, Diana, great, but what does mercy actually look like? Well, maybe for you, as you become a mercy hunter, you can notice what are the ways that God's love is tangible in your life. Do you have a roof over your head? Do you have food on the table? I mean, maybe it comes from some of those people that you care about and who care about you. They see the best in you. Do you have a few of those people in your life? That's mercy. That's love. Maybe for you, remembering the mercy and the goodness of God is you just need to get up a little bit earlier and listen to the birds out of your window. I mean, they are singing and making a new song. The love of God never fails. It's new every single morning. Can you be a mercy hunter? And maybe like days are tough. There are some of you who are facing things that are so difficult and so real. And as a church family, we are praying for you specifically today that God's mercy would be so obvious, that his love would be so near. We believe that because God's heart is for you more than ours ever could be. But maybe for you, remembering being a mercy hunter looks like hunting for the promises of God, pulling them up out of your Bible, pulling them up out of your memory, and saying, you know what's true about God? His very name says that he is Emmanuel, God with us, which means you and I are never alone. Maybe looking for the mercy means holding on to the trust that God, whatever I'm in right now, however difficult that relationship is with my spouse, with my coworker, with my child, that God, you can do something in that. New mercy means remembering the promise. It's his promise. It's not my hype. It's the promise of God that says his mercy is new every single morning. Will you be a mercy hunter? I have a friend, and her very name is Mercy. Isn't that ironic? She's a beautiful woman, and she lives in India, and she and her family right now are going around, and they are delivering bags of food to people in their community who genuinely have run out of food. They have no food to feed their family, and they have no option of figuring out how to get food. They have no finances, no way to get them. And Mercy and her family are showing up with bags and bundles of food that they are knocking on the door and saying, we love you. We just want to gift this to you. No strings attached. Can you imagine it? It gives me goosebumps every single time. Why? Because those families are experiencing Mercy's actions. The person, as she delivers the food, those families are experiencing a tangible reminder of the love and the goodness and the faithfulness and the mindfulness of God. They are remembering that God's love is tangible and invading their story. My question for you this morning is, will you be a mercy hunter? And hear me clearly. You can be a mercy hunter no matter what your season of life looks like. Whether you're stuck together with people or stuck apart, whether you are well along in years or whether you are just starting out, you can be a mercy hunter. Whether, you know, this has actually been a time of refreshment and rest and reconnection, or whether this has been one of the most brutal couple of days and weeks of your life, you can be a mercy hunter. Why? Because it's not dependent upon you. The promise of Jesus says, the promise of God, it says his mercy is brand new. Every morning, it's here. Will we notice it? I know as I've pondered this question, can I find it? It has brought life and hope back into my heart and my faith, and I think and I believe it will do the same for you. Will we be a mercy hunter? And maybe, for those of you who've been walking with Jesus for a while, maybe you'll even take it a step further and ask God, God, here I am. Could you use me to bring an expression of love and mercy to somebody else? I want to echo your love to my neighbors, to my family, to a stranger. Show me how. Show me how. Because the love of God is good and faithful and constant and steady. And the love of God demonstrated his love for us by sending his only son, Jesus, to the earth. And he lived this perfect, sinless life. But he chose to lay it down. He chose to take the punishment for you and I. And he chose to conquer death. And as he rose again, he made a way for you and I to come back into connection and relationship with Jesus. It's the best news. Do you remember the love of God? Have you noticed it even today? The one who is with you, the one who is walking with you, let's be mercy hunters. Would you pray with me? Jesus, thank you. Thank you that you know that our hearts and our souls grow weary sometimes. Sometimes for valid reasons and other times because we're just having a tough day. But God, you promise every single morning before we ever do anything to earn it or dis-earn it, you say love is available, mercy is new. So Jesus, I pray for my friends, every single heart and soul that is tuning in. God, would you help us? Would you help us notice your love and your mercy? Would you remind us of your promises that are sure and steady? And God, would you even right now give my friends ideas on how they can echo the love of God to others through a simple text message, through an action, through a prayer? God, we want to be a part of what you're doing. We love you. Help us be mercy hunters. Help us see you, Jesus. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Your plans for me are good. I know you hold my future and my home. Your promises never fail. Your promises never fail. Your promises never fail. Your promises never fail.
Jesus, we thank you for your word. We thank you for your truth. We thank you for your promises that never leave us, that never forsake us. Your promises that tell us we're never alone. You're with us, and we're in this thing together. So God, we thank you for your faithfulness. Jesus, we thank you for your sacrifice. We thank you for the freedom that we have in you. God, will you help us to lead those around us in your love and your grace and in your mercy? It's in your name we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, thanks so much for being here with us this morning. We hope that you were encouraged, and we can't wait to see you guys this weekend. We love you. Have a great day.